finally got the response from everybody's favorite, Drake. Drake finally responded to Kendrick, and apparently he got some disses for the whole rap game, because it's been looking like Drake versus the whole industry lately. So we got Drake push-ups dropping Give Me 50 lyrics by Drake. Let's get right into the video. Please show a like, comment, subscribe, share the video. Roll 300 subscribers. Comment down below who y'all got winning this beef. Is this song a W or L? Because apparently I was trying to avoid this, because apparently at first I thought it was, because I thought it was going to be like, people was like, Drake responded, Drake responded. I was expecting it to be another AI type thing. And then it's like, on Twitter, people was like, oh, it had been real, because a lot of reactors, their reaction getting taken down. So I was kind of hesitant still. At that point, I was even more hesitant, because I'm not trying to get no strike or anything. So, but apparently now I'm seeing people's reactions are being cleared to post. So I'm going to go ahead and record mine and hopefully get it. Hopefully I can break down some of the lyrics, but this ain't a lyric breakdown channel. But if we can break down the bars, we can. Let's get right into the video, though.
Nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for now.
Who is this about? Is this about Kendrick or no, cause I don't think Poetic, was Poetic Justice ever number one? I don't know, but I think that's about Future, actually, because Way Too Sexy, that was the first number one hit Future had. That's technically a Drake song, but it had Future on it. But I was never a fan. That song was overplayed and overhyped. But it did go number one. So he said, I put your first number one in your hand. You can't get booked out of America for nothing. For nothing, basically.
First number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for nothing. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker y'all depend on.
Because y'all know Metro Boomin, A lot of his songs that he produced be hits. Drake letting him know, I'm still the hit maker. Don't get it twisted. Because, you know, that Drake effect is still real. If you put Drake on your song, it's going to make it big. Just off the strength of Drake. Even J. Cole, when he was on his feature run, said, he don't got the Drake effect, but something.
I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't ever take no chain off of us. How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man's on?
That's what I'm like, is this for Future? Because a lot of this could be applied to Future. Because, like, you know, they used to be chill. Like, they used to chill together tight. Because it was OVO X, Free Baz, and Metro was cool with Drake. Produced a good bit for Drake. Or there could be applied to Kendrick, especially when he was like, because, you know, Kendrick was like, he taking chains, he snatching chains and pulling tattoos, burning tattoos, I mean. So I feel like, you won't ever take no chain off us. How you big stepping with a size 7 men's on, like size 7 shoe, but how you big stepping?
I'm the hit maker y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't ever take no chain off of us. How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man's on? This the part with the bite, nigga, what's up? I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up.
Because at this point, I'm not, these Aubrey Angels like, loose! Y'all get on my nerve with this. Y'all try to attack this angle of, it's the whole industry versus Drake right now. How y'all like my lost impersonation? But yeah, y'all really push this narrative that it's the whole, and then with a lot of these rappers coming to Metro Boomin and Future's album to throw shots, it's kind of looking like they right. It is starting to look like the Aubrey Angels are right, but yeah, it's like, you know, y'all, his picture on the wall, Drake making y'all rap. In a few videos ago, I said Kendrick was the reason that rap is kind of alive again. But apparently everybody got this energy for Drake out of nowhere. Like, Future and Drake, that was a beef I didn't see coming. Apparently people was like, on What Will Pluto Do or something like that, he dissed that. It was a diss that only Future would have gotten, and yeah. So yeah, it's like, it was a sub diss or whatever. But yeah, it's like, it's getting this angle, it's being pushed that Drake is making people want to rap again. So yeah. Extortion, baby, whole career, you been shook up. Cause top told you drop it, give me 50 likes of push-ups. Your last one brick, you really not on shit. They make excuses for you cause they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract cause we gotta see the split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop, you better drop and give them 50. Oh, that's better do that. Basically, he's saying Top Dog is who runs your whole career. Drop and give him 50. Give him, like, military. Drop and give me 50. Boy, I could be a drill sergeant. But not for real. That's what Drop and give him 50 is referring to. And then he was like, your last one brick, your last album sales-wise, like, that's what all these Drake, like, that's what every, I don't like the whole sales narrative that people try to pull on these artists. But I guess that's the one metric that a lot of people use to determine if an album is good or not, is sales. I mean, because that's the only objective, because music is very subjective. I get them to, I think it's subjective. Music is very opinionated, but to support your opinion, people feel like they got to come with facts, and the facts in this case would be the sales. So, yeah. A fucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop, you better drop and give them. And then that part, you from Compton got sung a Maroon 5 verse and Taylor Swift verse, but that was basically saying that ain't nobody behind that but Top Dog. You that ain't because you know you can't, you want to be on some conscious music, but you got to do more than that to appease your label. And you only getting 50% of that. So, yeah, that's what he's saying right there. Might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse. You better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop. You better drop and give them 50. Pip squeak pipe down. You ain't in no big three. Scissor got you wiped down. Travis got you wiped down. Savage got you wiped down. Like your label, boy, you in a scope right now. And you gon' feel the aftermath of what I write down. I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. Just to add his talk. Let's put SZA in your big three. Because SZA's not even a rapper. Basically, he's like, SZA, bro, Travis, got you wiped out. Basically, I think he's saying this. He's going from this with a whole sales perspective, I believe. Is the way he's coming at this. Because, like, Utopia outsold Mr. Morale, I believe. Yeah. Like in the Scope Records, you in Interscope Records, you in the Scope right now. Basically, I got my, you in my sights. So, yeah. Savage got you wiped down. Like your label, boy, you in the Scope right now. And you gon' feel the aftermath of what I write down. I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. Just to add this talk with your ass, I had to hike down. Big difference between Mike then and Mike now. What the fuck is this, a 20v1, nigga? What's a prince to a king? He a son, nigga. Get more. Fuck is this a 20. Difference between Mike then and Mike. You know, Mike then was a very peaceful Mike Jackson back then. There's Michael Jackson. Oh, that's cringy. But Drake is basically saying, Mike now, I ain't with the same piece that Mike back then was with. This a 20v1? You know, Prince is a king's son. And basically, you know, because Kendrick was saying he's Prince, because Prince, so I live Mike Jack. And then, you know, because Drake always compares himself. And then not only that, a king. What's the second person to a king? A prince. Basically, and then Michael Jackson has a son named Prince Jackson. And not only that, Michael Jackson was the king of pop. So Drake is saying he's a modern day king of pop.
He's a prince to a king, he a son, nigga. Get more love in a city that you run, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga.
He told him basically, so shut up and make some beats. Oh man, that's crazy.
Yeah, I'm the sixth guy, I'm the front runner. Y'all nigga manager was Charles' little blunt runner. Clean a six and you boys ain't even come from it. And when you boys got rich, you had to run from it. Cash blowing, able bread out here tricking. How you tricking? Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas. Jets, whips, chains, wicked, wicked, wicked. Spinning like you trying to fuck, boy, you tripping, boy, you tripping. Drizzy Chippendale, probably got your bitch in there. I just got him done, boy, don't make me at the Chippendale. Rolling loud stage, y'all would turn, that was slick as hell. Shit'll probably change if it be him, start to kiss and tear. Hugs and kisses, man, don't tell me about no switches. I'll be rocking every fucking chain I own next visit, ayy. I'll be with some bodyguards like Whitney Tops.
Did he just whip? That's Kendrick's girl name, man. Last time, you ain't learned from the last time you bought somebody wife into this? Oh my gosh, Drake, you might be done for at this point, my guy. Cause and then this part, he's like, I'll be rocking every chain I own next visit. Next time I come your way, I'm rocking all my chains. So let's see if you snatch one of them. Top say drop. Oh, I ain't made
it. Drop your little midget ass, better fuck it. Drop and give me 50. Ay. Niggas really got me out here talking like I'm 50. Niggas really got me out here rapping what I'm living. I might take your latest girl a cuff her like I'm Ricky. Can't believe he jumping in. This nigga turning 50. Every song that made it on a chart he got from Jizzy. Spin that.
Is that even true? Every song Rick Ross that got on the charts? Is it something with Drake? But yeah, that seemed out of nowhere too. Drake and Rick Ross having beef. Man. That wasn't needed.
Check, you gotta stay up out my business, nigga. Shout out to the hooper that be busting out the gritty. We know why you mad, nigga. I ain't even tripping. All that little heartbroken Twitter shit.
Look at this, my man's Ja Morant for. Come on now.
Bitches, this for all the top dogs. Drop and give me 50. Drop, drop. In that fucking song, y'all got to not start the beef with us. This shit been brewing in a pot, now I'm heating up. I don't care what Cole think, that dot shit was weak as fuck. Champagne tripping, he is not fucking easing up. Nigga calling top to see it.
Yeah, like, everybody noticed, like, they wasn't seeing eye to eye even before the diss. The diss just brought everything back to light again. That's really all that was.
Wanna piece it up, top, wanna piece it up, top, wanna piece it up. Nah, pussy, now you on your own when you speaking up. You don't roll deep to this, it's not fucking deep enough. Begging cops or not, boy, you not fucking beating us. Numbers wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking creeping up. Money wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking sneaking up. Corn ball, your show money, merch money, feed us. I'ma let you niggas work it out because I seen enough. This ain't even everything I know, don't wait the demon up. This ain't even everything I know, don't wait the demon up.
It's like, He's spitting in this, but like he couldn't settle. Like, well, I just wanted it to be like he had to go about it this way. I get it because it seemed like everybody in the industry is dissing him, and J. Cole backtracking his diss. It's like J. Cole seemed like the one person that was supposed to be on his side, but even he apologized, and apparently he got a song on the new album with them, and yeah, it's like. So yeah, that's like he got a, like he says, a 20-v-1, and Ja Morant even had to catch something. Like, why?
Drop and give me 50, all you fuck niggas teaming up.
What pot have you smoking on, Kendrick?
Yeah, drop a 50 bag for the mob in a spot. Drop a 50 bag, 29 for the thot. I was really, really trying to keep it PG.
Wow. W song, man. Comment down below who y'all got. If y'all team Drake, a team Kendrick, a team every, like at this point, team everybody else.